Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Don't be angry. Angerness is poisonous thing. It can produce in your heart the poison of enmity, poison of hatred, poison of jealousy against other people. So, when a person has these poisonous things in himself or herself, then the habit of lying, backbiting, and saying bad things is more common. Even the person looks other people with low gaze, like with lower level, and try to make jokes of other. This way, be careful that when we are angry with someone, and if we leave the relationship with other people and don't talk up to 3 days, then relationship with Ummah of Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is finished. So this way Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, when a person is not to talk with other Muslim person up to 3 days, then the relationship with my Ummah is broken. So this way, be careful. So your angerness should not be prolonged. If there is some sign of angerness comes in you, you try to control as quick as possible and try to forgive other people. That is more important. And if you control over other person to whom you are angry, then don't tease the person, don't hurt the person, don't harm the person, and don't treat harshly with that person, and don't abuse the person, and forgive the person and leave just for Allah. Then Allah will give you the reward of that. So this is very important for us. This way, a person who forgive other people at the time of angerness and controls the anger, that person will feel Allah's pleasure at the day of judgment. Very important for us. And keep in mind that if a person who is doing bad behavior with you, you try to do good behavior with that person. If a person who say you rude words, you try to say the good words to that person. If a person who is favoring you, helping you in difficult times, so you try to thank Allah and thank that person. And if in your life any time you become angry with that person, then remind in your mind that this person helped me at the difficult time, and now why I should angry with that person? Request Allah to control your anger. Very important. So this is important point, especially when we are angry with other person, we should turn towards Allah's special blessings, saying, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim." Similarly, Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha, she said, Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he never angry with any person throughout his life for his own job. But he was angry with other people just for Allah. If a person who was not to perform the compulsory act or something that is compulsory just for Allah, and if the person was not to do that one, then Holy Prophet was, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was to be angry with that person. And when Holy Prophet ﷺ, he was given the authority to give the chance other person, then he make the things easy for other person, and he was not to make the things difficult. And Aqid bin Amir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Holy Prophet ﷺ, he held my hand and then he said that if a person who want to cut off relationship with you, you have to continue with that one. If a person who want to leave you from himself or herself, like, and then you try to make the person more blessed or more near, just try to give the gift to make the situation more better. If a person who is harming you or teasing you, you try to forgive that person. Musa alayhi salam, he asked Allah, which thing is more favorite before you? Allah said to Musa alayhi salam, when a person having the authority to have revenge from someone, but the person forgive that person, is favorite before me. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he conquered, he occupied Makkah and he defeated the enemy of Quraysh, and whole Makkah was under his control. That time these kuffar and mushrikeen of Makkah, they were thinking that what type of relationship will be done with us, and what type of punishment we will get from Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because we have done so much torture and troubles for him and for his companions. At that time Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he held the door of Allah's house, and then he said, Allah is one. Allah has no partner. Allah fulfilled his promise and he succeeded me here, and he helped me, and he defeated the enemies. This is blessings of Allah. And that time he said to the people of Quraysh, what do you understand? That time the Quraysh people, they said, we expect goodness from you. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I will do the same thing what have been done by my brother Yusuf alaihi salam when he got control over his brothers. So he forgave those one. So I will forgive today. So then Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forgave all the people, all the enemies of Makkah and Quraysh Makkah. So this was the greatest blessings of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that even he got the authority, he got the power over the enemies, but he forgave. We should try to follow it. Inshallah, we will get success in this world and the world hereafter. Allah give us tawfiq. Ameen.